To battleground Canada now, where coalition, possibly the most tainted word in Canadian politics, has reared its head in the run-up to the 2015 federal election. In recent interviews, Justin Trudeau came out against the idea, while Thomas Mulcair left the door wide open to a possible joint venture with the third-party Liberals. For more on all this, I want to bring in Sun News contributor Adam Jambroni, who's live with me in studio. Good to have you with us.
Good to be here.
So, what is going on with the federal NDP? Certainly lots last week. The caucus chair has left the federal NDP. He's now knocking on the door of the provincial Ontario Liberals. The deputy leader, Libby Davies, she's leaving politics altogether. So lots going on there.
Yeah, I mean, I think we're going to see a lot happening in all three parties in the lead up to 2015. I mean, MPs have to make a decision now if they're responsible, whether they're going to seek re-election to give the parties time to find people. So you see Libby Davies, who has 20 plus years in politics, most of that at the federal level. So she's obviously making a decision not to run again. I don't think out of any internal distance, it's just that now's the time, or you commit to four more years. So you see some of this, a lot of parties preparing. We did see Glenn step down to run in Sudbury. I think it's making a mistake running for a government that seems to be on their last legs. I don't know really what the story is there. I guess we'll find out depending on it. I'm not sure he's even going to win the seat, though.
But it can't be good news for Thomas Mulcair having somebody leave to head to the Ontario Liberals of all the parties out there.
Well, I mean, look, that particular issue has to do with the power grab. I mean, I don't know what it is. The Liberals in Ontario are in government. He's currently in opposition. We'll see what goes on. It's a big caucus. I mean, even if the NDP form a national government, there's no, I don't really know what his chances of being a minister were. I mean, we're getting ahead of ourselves. You have to win an election first. Mm-hmm. So I think he saw an opportunity to go to a governing party, perhaps have a role there, although I suspect he's going to have a fight in a by-election since it is an NDP seat. So we'll have to see what ends up playing out there. I think we're going to see more of this in all of the coming months as you see longtime MPs making those decisions, if for no other reasons other than their own personal decisions.
From the NDP?
No, from all, I think the Tories.
I knew you were going to say that.
I think you're going to see from the Tories, the Liberals perhaps as well. You have a lot of MPs. This is the season over the next 4 months when we're going to see that.
Season for change. Okay, so what about leader Thomas Mulcair, who now at year end is opening up the possibility, or not closing the door, on a possible coalition with the Liberals? People, average Canadians, wondering, how do the leaders of the NDP and the Liberals, who are so fundamentally different, come together and unite? How does that work?
Well, I mean, look, this happens in virtually every other country with a parliamentary democracy, including, of course, the mother of our parliamentary democracy, England, where David Cameron, a conservative, has a coalition government with the Liberal Democrats, which are the center-left party. So,
it's mind-boggling, though.
I think what politicians have to think of is their responsibility to the people. Mm-hmm. And in the case of David Cameron in England, the other option would be to say, you know what, we can't get along, we can't do anything together, we're going to go and have another election immediately, within weeks of the past one. And I think when faced with those sort of scenarios, people say, well, hold on a second, really? People can't negotiate? I mean, ideally, sometimes coalition government's the best time. People have to negotiate. Everybody has to give, and it probably produces a fairly good government. It has, in the case of the UK, a very stable democracy and a stable government.
I guess the only goal, realistically, is to take out Prime Minister Stephen Harper and the Conservatives.
Well, I think all three parties at the federal level have one objective, and that is to win the election.
To govern.
That's why to be the government. All that is their stated objectives. It's fairly obvious to us. There was a recent poll that over half of Canadians now would be okay with some sort of coalition. People, I think, see it in the UK. They've seen it in other countries. It's unusual. He hasn't committed to it. I think there's a big difference in saying we might do a coalition and then the particulars of what that coalition would look like. And besides, you still have to be in a position to form a coalition. For all we know, Stephen Harper could win a majority government.
Absolutely.
And in which case, it's not an issue.
Although the latest polls at year end look as though it would be leading towards a minority conservative government. Yeah. And that's why this whole coalition has come up. But why do you think Thomas Mulcair is open to it and Justin Trudeau is so against it?
My guess is Thomas Mulcair is being more honest than Justin Trudeau. I mean, let's be honest. If the Liberals are in a position to consider toppling Stephen Harper, I suggest they're going to. If they were given an option of being the government or being in opposition, really? I suspect the Liberals would go for a coalition. Now, there's a whole bunch of questions. What would that coalition? That's why I said it a minute ago. You open the door to consideration of it. It's a far cry to say, you know what, we think about it. We be honest, we consider it. And then actually say, we're signing on the dotted line, here's a coalition. There are so many questions between those two. I think it's probably dishonest of the Liberals to say, we're absolutely not, because I think if the conditions were right and they were in a position of power to have that, they would at least consider it,
right,
whether they actually went through with it.
So anything should be on the table.
I think it's not necessarily should be on the table. I think the reality is, if you want to be honest about it, people are at least thinking about it, and so you might as well be honest and say that.
Well, we're certainly talking about it. Adam Gembroni, thank you for being with
My
us.
My pleasure.
Good to see you. Okay.